Today, we are going to talk about VR180 stabilization. We'll compare all the VR180 camera available in the market right now to show you none of them has enough internal stabilization to compare to 60 cameras. This is why I have a stabilization suit on with the Mozart Air gimbal from Gimbal Guru and the Zcam K1 Pro on top with the Mozart Air 2 and the Y-axis stabilization suit to remove up and down walking movement. This is how I achieve professional level stabilization on VR180 rig. But you ask, what about for consumer with consumer VR180 camera like the Insta360 EVO I have on here? Or what about the Vuze XR behind me? Well, as you see this rig I'm holding right now, right here, you can use this to achieve the same result as my heavy rig right here. So, let's break this down and see how to achieve perfect stabilization for VR180. So now we have all four most popular consumer VR180 camera right here. From left to right, we have the Daydream, Lenovo Mirage, and then we have the Vuze XR, then we have the Insta360 EVO, and then we have the Kandao Qoocam. All four camera in the exact same distance, and we're gonna walk with it to see how good is the stabilization. Let's find out. As you see the walking test for normal use, both EVO and Qoocam are pretty stable. The Google Lenovo Mirage is okay, and the Vuze XR is pretty shaky. When I start to run, that is when you see the stabilization breakdown. Vuze XR is unusable, Mirage has pretty bad up and down side to side movement, even the horizon line kept pretty straight. Qoocam is acceptable, but the horizon line is not straight. EVO is the best overall, but you can still see minor vibration, especially around the lens edges. If you watch this in a VR headset, everything looks worse because now image in the left and right eyes are both moving, which create vertical parallax that make people sick subconsciously. So now we have just a regular Insta360 EVO and another EVO on top of my Osmo Mobile first and then my vertical stabilizer to compare how good is the stabilization between these two cameras. Let's find out. So when putting side by side EVO with only flow state and EVO with flow state and gimbal, you can tell with the gimbal version is a lot smoother. Besides, it feels less shaky in the headset, the gimbal version also looks sharper and less motion blur than without gimbal. I'm not sure what kind of magic Insta360 using on flow state, but I guess it involves calculation to hide motion blur. So image quality will improve if you less rely on flow state. My Osmo Mobile is not so good at locking horizon. If you use the slightly more expensive Mozart Guru 360, it tends to have a better result. So now you see the comparison result in 2D. If you want to watch this in your VR headset, I provided the download link below in my description. Now let's see how I used to build my stabilization system. Other YouTuber keep saying EVO right here does not have a good design. I had to disagree. The box looking EVO is in perfect shape to put on any handheld cell phone gimbal. I use my very old DJI Osmo right here, Osmo Mobile. It worked out of the box for Lenovo Mirage, and that's what I have been using for many jobs before any other VR180 cameras. EVO does not fit in Osmo out of the box, as you see right here, but I put a tripod mount right here and a phone right here, and it will fit nicely. Check this out. Boop. See? What about Vuze XR? It's a great camera, by the way. Great color science out of the box, and the image look very sharp. Not to mention it support ProRes render for those who like post-production and want to make their footage look as good as possible. But you cannot move the Vuze XR unless you pair it with the Mosaic Guru 360, like what I'm using right now, because the shape and the weight of a Vuze XR, the cheapest and the easiest option is actually right here, this thing. Again, feel free to use regular DSLR gimbal right here and the counterweight. That will also work for Vuze XR as well. But a handheld gimbal is not enough if you are walking and not on wheels. I film a lot of VR180 actually on my one wheel. When humans walk, there's up and down motion, which is unavoidable if you are human with 2 feet. So to counter that, we have this little guy right here. It's easily attached onto any handheld gimbal right now and provide the Z axis stabilization. If you use a heavier DSLR gimbal like I have right here, you can try this guy. This guy can help you support heavier gimbal like the Mosaic Air 2 or any DSLR gimbal. So don't worry, I will provide all the link down in the description below so you can check them out. Thank you for watching this VR180 stabilization. In the next video, actually in VR180, you will see the difference with a without a stabilization system like I built right here for both the Insta360 EVO, Vuze XR or the Qoocam K1 Pro. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a like and hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed yet, and I will see you next time.